tap and a series of taps, or the particular sound has developed from the alveolar stop is not known. In this area, detailed research is needed, and we have to find a lot of things, and we have to. And so, anyway, the stop sound has changed the quality. And I won't say it's changed the quality because it's available. The sound is available after it is pronounced after the nasals, and it is pronounced as when it is doubled. But when as a single stop, that is changed. One reason may be, perhaps one, there may be one reason, because we don't have a separate script for the alveolar stop and alveolar trip. So we write in as an alveolar trill and pronounced as an alveolar stop. That may be the reason why the sound is. So that is why I have given within brackets that alveolar sound. Because in Tolkappian's period, it was a clear stop. Then after the contrast between r and ra, it is very much clear that the sound as no script, and that is the present position. Okay, so very briefly, Tamil alphabet makes use of only the voiceless stops. Alveolar and retroflex stops do not begin the word. Consonant clusters are not permissible either at the beginning or at the end of words. And ra and la cannot commence the word. This is the classical Tamil consonant classification. But as you all know, changes are inevitable in languages. And the changes may be natural as well as non-natural. Natural changes happens due to in course of time due to so many factors. Non-natural changes also are gradual, same time happens because of the loans. And so because of the one thing which is now clear is, in modern Tamil, the language has occurred a number of voiced stops. Perhaps this may be due to loans. Okay. So, I only say that these sounds which were allophones have changed to phonemes. So, when I say change in a phonetic system, it may be either a phonemic change or a phonetic change or a morphophonemic change. So, mainly the stops have changed the quality. That is, we have acquired lot of, the voiced stops. So, we know the principle, that is, in allophonic distribution, we say, guys consider are these voice stops are considered, there are phones are allophones of the voiceless sounds, and we say the voiced sounds occur in such and such positions and voiceless sounds elsewhere. So, but we get a clear contrast in the initial positions of the word. So that particular statement, that is phonemic description, is ruled out here because of the contrast available in the initial position. And in the next figure, I give the modern Tamil sounds. We have the non-syllabic sounds, abstinent, sonorant, nasals, liquids, lateral, flap, trill, stops. They have voice and voiceless, and they also have fricatives. A few fricatives, now we say fricatives are occurring in the intervocalic position. Now they have also, so this is the present modern system of Tamil. My beloved teacher, Dr. Vijay Venugopal sir, who taught me the first letter of linguistics, dear delegates and friends, the title of my paper is Adverbial Nouns in Tamil, a Historical Study. This paper aims to illustrate the adverbial nouns, that is the noun function as the adverb, historically from Tolhapiyam period to the modern period. The traditional grammarians are not dealt with the nouns which function as adverbs. Modern grammarians or descriptive grammarians have also not discussed them sufficiently. A few modern grammarians treated them under particles. Krishnamurti observed the function of nouns in as adverbs in Tamil and in other Dravidian languages. Caldwell also has mentioned about the adverbial nouns. While Tolhapiyam enumerates 9 patterns of the verbal participles, he lists the 6 forms, Pin, Mun, Kal, Kadai, Pali and Idath in a separate sutra. These forms are not terminal suffixes but are real free forms and they can function as nouns denoting place or time. But the forms Kal and Kadai do not denote place and do not occur in any other syntactic usages. Chennavarayar describes this sutra as constituting these 6 forms that denoting the time of an action and occur in final possession. So they can be considered as verbal participle, that is vinayacham. But their occurrence in the phrasal construction like vandapin, varumun, vandakal, vandakade, etc. show the characteristics of relative participle. As the commentator says, among these forms, only pin can occur in the verbal participle construction as kandupin. Hence, these examples give supportive evidence that they are nouns. L.V. Ramaswamy IAS observation also seems to support this suggestion. He says, TC 229 refer to the forms constituted of relative participles. The conditional meaning of forms like vandakal would arise when these forms modify indeterminate and are future verb forms. In the earlier stages of Sangam Tamil, such conditional forms are rare. The restriction of the form vandakal to the pure conditional appears to have been comparatively of a later period. Israel points out that this type of construction is the pattern of adverbial expression. Further, he explains it's thus. If 2 or more words, that is say the pattern of relative participle and noun, which as one unit have the function of an adverb, they may be identified as an adverbial expression. Usually, nouns are not only inflected for different cases, but also are distinguished for numbers, vice, singular and plural. But there is a set of nouns denoting time or place which are not distinguished for number, gender, but are inflected for certain cases. They are real.